Here we go.
Hi, my name is Mario Sucata. I'm a BJJ black belt. Started jiu-jitsu in 1991. You want me to look at you or look at the camera?
Yeah, you can look at me.
1991, and the place called João Pessoa, that's my city, that's where I come from, in the north of Brazil. Yeah, later on, I came to live in Rio de Janeiro, where I trained with Carson Grace. And when Carson went to America, and then I moved to BTT. And stayed BTT for about a year, trained with BTT for a year, and then I moved to Holland, where I had a chance to train in the Golden Glory team. After that, I stayed there for 6 months, and then I moved to England, where I stayed even to today. Like, I came in England in 2004, England. And today I'm head coach of the World Slayer Gym in Liverpool. I'm training Michael Bisping, Quinton Rampage Jackson, Jack Congo, those guys all train with me. I do the MMA and the jiu-jitsu when they fight. Yeah, in England, my gym is more about MMA, but my background is Brazilian jiu-jitsu, so I'm always pushing, I always try to make them understand how important the jiu-jitsu is for the fight. Jiu-jitsu. I still believe jiu-jitsu is the hard part of the MMA.
Yes.
Okay. And today we might not see much submissions in MMA, but also we don't see good jiu-jitsu fighters in MMA.
Yes.
All right. That's the way I see.
Yes.
You can survive, but you don't have like well. We have them in my. For me, it's like is the jiu-jitsu guy at the moment in MMA. Like he got six fights, six submissions this round, and then he showed the pure jiu-jitsu. And I still believe how jiu-jitsu is the most important fight, the most important part of the MMA today.
When did you started to do MMA outside the jiu-jitsu?
I'm a fighter myself as well. So my first fight was 1995.
95.
Yeah. A pure MMA, vale tudo. No rules. Bare knuckles. Yeah. Kicks in the head, elbows in the face, everything.
Those were the rough days.
Yes, that was like years ago. And that's my first fight, 1995. I got 19 fights as an MMA fighter. I was 4, so that makes me 15-4. And MMA. My last fight was November last year. Unfortunately, I got beat, but I ain't give up yet. So at the end of August this year, I got one more fight in England.
Okay. So you're still going at it.
Yeah, like always one more fight left.
Good.
It's hard to say. No, I have to retire now. Yeah, that's really hard to accept this.
So how are the English guys adapting jiu-jitsu, submission, vale tudo? Are they catching up with the rest of?
Yeah, I still saying like I can't even say like jiu-jitsu is a new sport in England. So MMA, like, they have MMA for a couple of years, but about 3 years ago the UFC came to it got back to England,
yes.
And then this sport become bigger, but. They mix it up a little bit, like they believe jiu-jitsu. Some guys still believe jiu-jitsu is MMA. they fight with no gi. They think you have to train with no gi to be an MMA fight. And in my opinion, the evolution is. You have to start with gi, and then you learn more, and then you start training with no gi. Okay, that's the way I see it. But my fighters and my students, because I got a class and I got a pro fight team. As I said before, I always try. I'm always pushing them to do the jiu-jitsu, the really basic stuff. But they I make sure they're gonna learn the basic right, and the same stuff they learn there, they're gonna say, might gonna save him one day in a cage,
yes,
or might gonna help him one day in a cage. So, as I said, the sport's still new in England. They still like understanding what it is, but there's a big, massive potential in England. The English, I believe also, because the English people are very like, they are hooligans. Let's use this word.
Tough guys.
Yeah, they are tough. They are tough. So the English guys have a big, big potential.
Big potential.
Big potential, yeah. And we don't only have Michael Bisson, but we have like, we got Teddy Etten, we got Paul Kelly. Those guys are all English guys. And they've been doing really good at the UFC. So in the next couple of years, more English guys are going to be fighting, not only in UFC, but in MMA scenario. So
okay.
I see like a very bright future for
there's a bright future
in England, yes, for that.
And there is soon going to be a big open competition in Jiu-Jitsu as well, I think, in London.
Yeah.
Is it the English Open or something like that?
No, it's not. They have last month the British Open. No, the Bristol Open.
Yes.
I'm not sure about what the competition is going to call. I think the Grace Invitation. They have every year Grace Invitation, and it is in London. So,
is it growing fast,
yes,
in England?
Yes, yeah, I don't really know how many black belts they have in England, but there's not that much, but they have a lot of gyms.
Okay.
A lot of gyms. And then the competitions like become like, let's say, the last year we had 5, this year we're going to have 8 or 10. So, yeah, it's growing fast.
It's growing, and there's a lot of potential over there.
Of course, there is.
And that's actually basically to get this real potential and develop the base. Actually, it still is jiu-jitsu. If the base is really good,
if you have a good base in jiu-jitsu, and if you learn the pure technique, if you learn right, of course you have a good base. And not only in jiu-jitsu, but in any martial art.
Yes.
Yeah, I believe the base, the first couple of months, at any, whatever martial arts you start, have to be the best as possible. If you learn right, and the future is going to teach right, you're going to use the way you learn. That's the way I see it.
So maybe we can visit you at your gym in Liverpool.
Yeah, it would be a pleasure. Liverpool, don't forget, Wolf Slayer Gym, Liverpool. So anytime, Monday to Friday.
Oh, nice. But then I think we're going to see you in the future, because I hope we're going to get over there, and then we're going to make another interview.
Oh, for sure. Definitely.
Okay.
We're going to meet you again.
Perfect.
Right.
Thank you.